Hi, it's Chris. Welcome to the second episode of Things That You Should Know in Grasshopper. There's been a great response to the Grasshopper Basics series. Thank you guys. It will be even a greater pleasure to continue making a video in this series. In today's episode, I will show more stuff that every Grasshopper user has to know. For some of you, this video will only serve as a knowledge refreshment, though worth watching by absolute everyone. Enjoy! Let's start with the first one, relay. When your script gets bigger and bigger, you will have more connections. There will be several inputs going to several outputs and vice versa. With several wires in the one place, you can easily lose your track. Wires can go on each other, and you will don't know which one goes to which component. With help comes relay component. In order to create a relay on your wire, you need to just double-click on your connection. Afterwards, you can connect output of relay and connect it to the several components. So you can grab all your wires into one relay and afterwards connect to other components. You can also create relay component manually. Go to params, util, and grab it from the ribbon. Moreover, you can also give the names to your relays. In this way, you can have order in your script and give the special names to the wires. Just right-click on your component, and in the empty box, write relay name. Zoom. This function saved me a lot of times. For sure, many times you have clicked on your component in Grasshopper, and it was not visible in Rhino. Most likely, your element is far away from the view. Zoom scrolling on your perspective window in Rhino will not help you to find it. So when you would like to find your element in Rhino, just select your component so it will be green. Afterwards, click middle mouse button and click magnify glass to zoom to the Rhino. So again, when you lose your track in Rhino and you click on your element in Grasshopper and it's not visible, just click middle button of your mouse and magnifying glass to zoom into your Rhino. Direction. In the last episode of Things You Should Know in Grasshopper, I showed you how to visualize a vector. Here I will show you that order of creating things in Grasshopper really matters. Let's look closer to this example. We have two points, starting point and ending point. Here we create a line with these points and another line with reverse order. To visualize the direction of the curve, we are going to use evaluate curve. As an input parameter, we are going to put 1 to see tangent vector at the end of this curve. And as you can see, when you connect our tangent to vector display, that these two curves have different directions. So remember, order matters in Grasshopper. Param viewer. For all beginners, it's hard to get how data tree structure works. And I understand that because I had problems too. For all users that start the journey with Grasshopper, I really recommend to use Param Viewer component. You can visualize how data tree structure works. Double click on canvas, search for Param Viewer. You can find it in params and util. And connect to this component your data tree. In my case, there will be a points. So now you can see how many branches is in your data tree and how many elements. When you double click, you can visualize your data and see how this tree looks like with all the elements and branches. And the last one for today, point list. When you have a group of points, it can be super useful to have an order in that point group. Use point list components to visualize the numbers of points. It will help you to connect correct points to each other. You can also visualize the size of the points in the Rhino, or even bake it to have them as objects in Rhino. That's all for today. If you would like to learn and read more about Grasshopper, I have prepared a free Grasshopper guide. 20 pages filled with books, exercises, and tutorials about Grasshopper. Everyone will find something for themselves. In order to download the guide, please click the link in the description below. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Have a good one.